Poor Peach is having a bit of a fit. I took her eggs because she's just so obsessed. And it's been, God, Peach, it's been about a month. So she's just trying to figure this out. Get your seeds, but then you have to get out of the pot.
Come on, Peachy. Come on.
I know, honey. Got them over there in that blue bag. No, don't get back in there. I know, Peach. I'm sorry, honey. It's a gorgeous day. The kids and I are going to go out to St. George's for a drive and just walk around a little bit. And I want to get some little yarn. I'm making some of those little tiny little creature things that I made before. I'll show you later. Come on, oh Peach. Come on. Over the pot. Good chicken. Good job. Jump. Come on. Jump. Out. Go for it. I just got some of my yarn. Girls are just down taking a photo. And driving the car in a big empty parking lot with your foot on. Okay. Not fast, Bryn.
This is not fast.
I don't enjoy it.
Are you okay back there, Carrie?
Better dive.
Okay, brake. Slow down.
Why?
Because I'm just getting you to get used to the brake. I love the blinker. Okay, going way too fast.
No, I'm not.
Slow down.
That's.
You're scaring your mother.
I'm going
I can't
10.
Get my leg over to the brake.
Jesus,
Quinn! Scott and I are just coming to Bocce for date night. He refuses to take a picture with me. That's fine. Nice little Italian restaurant, right off the golf course. We're going over there to the little speciality, where's my finger? Speciality grill over that way. So we're just in town. We brought the bikes just because I thought there was some events going on in town today, but there's a lot of parking, so we would have been okay. There's City Hall. So we're gonna go see Jurassic Park. Or Jurassic World, I think it's called. So the kids and I are in an area called Southlands. There's this sign here. It's a little spooky. We refer to these as monkey trees. It just looks like trees where monkeys would be. Just down around the turn of this road is the Swizzle. I think you can see it from here. Going to get hit by a car, but it's just down around that turn is the Swizzle restaurant. So I've always wanted to come in through here and take some pictures, but I was never going to do this by myself.
Isn't this trespassing?
No, it's no. It's an old... No, but there's a historic home up in here apparently. Look at this. Look, the branches from that tree hang right down. Look. Isn't that cool? Ooh, I don't know if I should pull on it. Ooh. Okay, that's scary. We're not gonna die. But you see why I wouldn't come up here alone. So I figured I'd put my children in danger too. No, I think this is it. It's gotta be. No, it's not a gravestone. It's a rock. This is just probably part of the railway trail. Here, Kerrigan, run up there and see what's up there. Come on. We're not trespassing. Yeah, the path narrows quite a bit up there. All right, we're gonna board our mission based on spookiness. Let's go to the beach where there's other people. That's not so scary. Can you imagine coming through here in the dark? We should try that. I'm talking to both of you. You want to do that in the dark? It's too spooky.
I just like
Today I'm heading into town. I have to take back the cable box because we sold Bryn's TV, so there's no use for the cable box anymore. She wasn't watching it, so there's no point. I'm filming with my phone lately. I'm just trying it out. I prefer my video camera, but this is just more convenient because I can take a smaller purse with me. And I have to buy some birthday presents for Bryn. Her birthday is this Saturday. Hard to believe, she's gonna be 15. Good Lord, where did that time go? All right, so we're off to town. I'll do a little bit of video if I see anything interesting. All right, off we go.
I don't know what the ship is or why they're here, but it's kind of cool.
Having a bit of a conflict. Peach is surrounding me like she knows. She tried to attack me a minute ago. I'm sorry, Peach. You just don't want to know, honey. it's too much for you to handle. Go find some bugs in the grass or something. It's a nice night out here, so I thought I'd come sit with the chicken and make some little creatures. I'll show you the ones I've done so far. These are my little creatures. I made a chicken and a little mermaid. Hang on, there's a thread in her hair. It's a little mermaid with her little purple shell top. And I made a monkey. He still needs to hold a banana, but I need to get some yellow and brown yarn. And I did a little elephant. A little elephant. Hang on. Oh, itchy nose. It's my little guy. And then I just did a little fish. Wait, it's upside down. Here's my little goldfish. And then I did a little ghost, which I'd like to do a few of. Whoops. One-handed. I'd like to make a few of these and make like a little ghost garland. Yes, Peach. No, Peach! God! Okay! Okay, okay! No, 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 no! Oh my god! Oh my god! No, no, you have to go! Peach. Oh my god! No! Stop pecking! Okay, okay, nice, Peachy. Don't poop on my stuff. Don't poop on my book. Okay, okay, chicken. Oh, sweet Lord. Jeez. Why do I own a chicken? Oh my god. Okay, okay, that's fun. That's so relaxing outside. Oh, sweet God. Okay, anyway. Whew. Oh, chicken. What the hell was that? Okay, so here's my little dinosaur I'm working on.
So I'm knitting on, well, it's three needles and you use a fourth one. And I did a dishcloth tutorial before, and oh my god, my nose is so itchy. I did a dishcloth tutorial before, and I showed you how to knit a dishcloth, so I might do a lesson someday about knitting on three needles. So yeah, it's kind of cool. It's neat how it works, but all of those little things were worked pretty much the same way, and I'll show you how to do I-cord as well, which is like this. That's really pretty easy. It's a little fumbly, especially with something this small, but yeah, it can be done. So just getting started is a little tricky, but yeah, so, all right, got a flip-flop mark on my feet. All right, I'm gonna go back to knitting and saving myself from the chicken. Here's all my yarn that I've been using. It is, the stuff that I have here is actually mercerized, I've never said that word before, Egyptian cotton. This color is apple, but the other stuff I have is this. Yes, Peach, I know. Do you like the yarn? Okay. This is just Patton's 100% cotton 4-ply. So I ordered some chocolate brown and some yellow, so I'm waiting for that to arrive. So those are my colors that I have. Yes, Peach, off you go. Okay, bye, chicken. And then I don't have black, so I've just been using this crochet stuff. And inside here, I have a whole bunch of little squares that I had made at one point. I was gonna make something, I don't know what, so I just have a whole bunch of them shoved down in here. Yeah, so they just live in there. Anyway, back to my dinosaur. I'm a chicken. God, she got my pickle. What dirt. Oh, good lord.
I just wanted to show you some mail I got this morning. This is from Christine out in California, and she sent me a nice letter. Thank you, Christine. And she was talking about Disneyland and Disney World. She was watching my vlogs that I did in Disney, and look what she sent me. Disneyland and California Adventure. Isn't that cool? They're the park maps. I've never been to California. So I've never been to Disneyland. How cool is that? Mariel used to live in where'd she live? Cupertino. They lived in California for 3 years, and they just moved back to Florida. My God, how long has she been back? How long have you been back? A year? A year, I think. Just over a year. A year in March, I think it was. But yeah, they moved there for 3 years. And she got to go to Disneyland, and she absolutely loved it. And my friend Krista is from Oregon, but she's been to Disneyland, and my friend Stacy, who you met, she's from LA. That's why you'll hear Mariel and I talking like that, because we tease her that she's from LA. Thank you, Christine. That's so cool. And she also sent me a newspaper article about the little free library, you know, the little library I showed you guys. There's one in, where is it, Sacramento? Sacramento. Isn't that cool? And she's going to make one this summer in front of her house. So that's really cool. And then she also sent me business cards for her daughters. Her daughters are home this summer, so she's very excited about that. And they're going to do some traveling. But yeah, both of her daughters are home. So one daughter is named Paige, and that's her business card that she had sent me. I'm just going to hold it still so you can see it. So she is a book reviewer and blogger. And then her other daughter, Kaylin, is a graphic designer, which that's what I am. How cool is that? I went to George Brown College in Toronto for graphic design. And this is Kaylin. Now, the only thing is, Kaylin's number is on the bottom, and I don't know if I'm to share that, because I did look at your designs, Kaylin, very cool, on your website, and I didn't see your number listed, so I'm just going to show it like this so people can see it. There we go. But yeah, I didn't know if that was going to be considered creepy to show your phone number, so I'm not going to show that. But yeah, I don't want crazy people calling you. Oh, and then she said she's starting to recognize the places on the island, like Dockyard, but she said, sometimes I think you're about to have an accident because I'm not used to driving on the left. How long did it take you to get used to that? It wasn't too bad. It's easier to drive a scooter because there's no steering wheel and you're not on the wrong side of the car, so that's obviously easier. It wasn't too bad, but I will not drive in Canada or the States. Like, I just don't trust my brain to flip to the other side of the road because you just get so used to it and now it's just normal. And when we do get back from Canada, I still have to tell myself, okay, left side. And you'll see in our videos when we went on the cruise, we flew to Miami and then drove up to Fort Lauderdale, and coming out of the airport parking lot, Scott's like, okay, right side. And I think he did that in Florida too. You just kind of have to like really think about it, and yeah, I'm not willing to do that. So I don't drive when we go to North America at all. So what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to do a field trip with you guys. It's about 1:15, so I don't have to get the kids for a couple hours. But I thought I would take you to the Palm Grove Gardens. I've driven by there many times, and I've actually wanted to go on my scooter because if I get up there and it's weird, it's just easy to turn around and get out of there on a scooter. Apparently it's like this public garden place. I don't really know what's there, but I figured I'd bring you and bring my sketchbook and we'll just see what's there. Why do I try? Seriously? God. Oh. Oh my God, I'm totally in someone's driveway. Don't mind me. Just trying to get turned around. Okay, I'm going. Alright. Although you have a lovely home. Oh my God. This is why I wish I had my bike. You're not open Friday, Saturday, Sunday, and apparently not Wednesday either. Well, you could put the sign down by the entrance, could you not? Do you ever have a day where you just shouldn't leave your house? I'm having one of those days. I think I'm missing my friends. I'm missing Mariel and Stacy. I'm missing Florida. All right, I really have nowhere to go. Home? Art store in town? Do I want something from the art store? Do I? I don't need anything. Okay, guess we're just going home. I think I'm just bored. There's nothing to do. And no one to do it with. I know some people here, but nothing. It's not the same. It's not the same as Mariel and Stacy and Jeanette and Krista and Lisa, all those guys that I hung out with in Florida. They were my friends, and I miss them terribly. Spend money. Mariel needs to come visit. You need to come visit me, Mariel. Okay, thanks. I mean, don't get me wrong. This place is beautiful. Yes, I show you the beaches and stuff, and oh, it's pretty. It's like if you lived, I don't know, where's the Grand Canyon? Arizona? I'm sorry. I don't know. I think it's in Arizona. Oh, that's ignorant of me. Anyway, it'd be like if you live near the Grand Canyon. Do you go to the Grand Canyon every day? No. Yes, it's spectacular, and yes, it'd be wonderful to see, but you wouldn't go see it every day. It's like here with the beaches. Like, okay. Like, it's pretty, but I don't want to see it every day. And it's sandy. I don't like sand. Oh, I can go by the little library. No, I don't need another book. I'm trying to... God, stop. Oh, someone's calling me. Someone's reaching out. I'm not supposed to be on my phone in the car. Oh, it's school. Shh. Hello? Hi.
Hi.
You okay?
What are you doing?
I'm just driving around. What? Do you need me to come there?
Yeah, I don't feel good.
You're not good? Okay. I'll be there in 5 minutes. Not even.
Okay.
I'm right by Cobb's Hill.
Yeah.
Okay. Bye. Bye. Oh, I have a sick baby I get to tend to. God, she better not be throwing up. I don't like when they throw up. Just keep all fluids in your body. Oh, I'm such a germaphobe. Oh, poor thing. What is wrong with her? That's weird. Like, she has to be really not feeling good for her to call. She's never done that. Kerrigan usually calls because she gets hit in the head with a football or something. Random explosions and things. It's usually a big deal for when they call. Oh, that can't be good. Oh, Jesus, now what? Hello? Hello?
Hello?
Hey.
Did you get a call from school?
Yeah, I just got a call from Bryn. She's sick.
What's wrong with her?
I don't know. I'm just going to get her now. She said she's not feeling good. So, I'm just on Cobb's Hill. I went to go to that garden place and it wasn't even open, so I just turned around and I was heading home.
Okay.
So, I'm just right on Cobb's Hill anyway. Yeah, I almost didn't get it either, so, because I was driving and I just figured it might be you and I would check it in a minute, so.
Yeah, alright, well, give me a quick text when you get home.
Okay, yep.
Okay, bye.
Bye. I better turn the camera off because she'll kill me. She'll be like, why are you videotaping this? You gotta love a teenager. You have to. It's actually the law, I think. I think you have to. You can't put them out until they're 18, I think. No matter what their mood. Alright, let's go get her. Just at the pharmacy, the grocery store. The kids just ran in to get something at the bakery, and I need a croissant before I bite my own face. I'm so hungry right now. Okay, so poor Bryn, she's okay, but she came out of school crying. She was in one of her classes, and she was in her food and nutrition class, and they were cleaning up and getting the kitchen all clean and organized and cleaned out for the summer. And she was given a popsicle and she ate half of it and then looked at the ingredients and it said it may, or processed in a factory that may contain peanuts and nuts. So then she panicked. So there wasn't, she's fine. It was just like a regular popsicle, like, by the sounds of it. But the fact that she didn't read the ingredients first sent her into a bit of a panic, and then she didn't want to freak anybody out, but she was totally scared that she was having some kind of anaphylactic reaction, which she wasn't. It was just more of like a I think probably a panic attack. So she's okay, she's totally fine. So we just basically played hooky for the afternoon and we just walked around town because I didn't feel like going home, and she was fine. So but yeah, she was terrified. So she will always read ingredients, and she usually does. I don't know why she didn't do it, but it sounded like it was just ice and water, so she's good. And here they are. All right, see ya.
Still bored.
Do something with yourself, right?
I know, there's nothing to do. Come do a husband and wife question thing with me. Oh. I was looking up concerts in Halifax for the Christmas season.
Oh, and yeah.
All this stuff was like John Mellencamp and Nickelback and all these people. Yeah, I know, I did the same thing. I was logged on to Los Angeles for some reason. Let's move there. Is it raining again?
It's raining.
Again.
Oh,
It would help if we knew the words. Come back! I'm bored.
Hey guys, how you doing? Today is Friday, June 19th. How you doing? I didn't film anything yesterday. Yesterday was just, I don't know, this past week I just haven't really felt like doing anything. I haven't felt like doing anything creatively. Wednesday I tried to come up with a Father's Day card in a box and I feel really bad, but I just could not get into a creative groove. So there's no Father's Day card. Sorry about that. I was gonna do a card in a box design and it wasn't happening the other day. So it's really hot in here. Right now I'm about to start housework because tomorrow is Bryn's birthday and Sunday is Father's Day. So I just want the house clean and tidy and nice, and I've been putting it off all week because I just knew it would get messed up again and I didn't want to do housework twice. So I have to do that. It's a gorgeous day out, so I'm going to go on a field trip somewhere with you guys. I have no idea where. We'll go somewhere. So it is 10 after 9 right now. I just put in another load of laundry. I just folded, I think, 3 loads of laundry. I have one in the dryer, one in the wash. I gotta do another one. Oh my god. I swear to god, there's always, it never stops. These little things that I was knitting, the little creatures, I want to take the chicken design and make a little cardinal. I'm gonna try to create a cardinal from that same pattern and then do some Project Life, because I know some of you have been wanting to see some Project Life videos, so I will get to that. And I still need to clean up the computer with files and stuff. You know what? After all that with me trying to find the disc and everything for my drawing tablet, I didn't have the USB cable plugged in the back of the computer. That's all it was. Because Scott said, he goes, it's kind of hard to delete a program. Like, it's more than just pushing a button and deleting it to wipe it off the computer. And I'm like, well, I don't know. I don't know what's happening. And then I went to use the scanner to scan one of my drawings, and I was in the mood to draw and everything, and I'm like, oh my god, the scanner doesn't work. Like, what is happening? And then my program wouldn't work, and even though I reloaded the software, it was like, that's weird. It was the yellow triangle with the exclamation mark. I'm like, that's bad. Something's wrong with this. And then the next day, Brent said, Mommy, the scanner's not working. And I finally clued in. I didn't. When the computer was dying the other week, because I had 14,609 photos and videos I may have mentioned, I panicked and I unplugged everything from the back of the computer, which was the scanner, which was my tablet. Yeah, so after all that, Scott just, he just rolled his eyes. 9:17 right now. So, I'm gonna go and see if I can get this done. I wanna be done by 11 o'clock and then get showered up and get cleaned up and get out, because it's going to be a beautiful day. It looks like, anyway. So, all right, get moving, Tanya. I'll be back. Okay, I just finished drying my hair and I am hot. Okay, it is 11:15. It took me to 10:40 to finish housework. Pretty close to my goal. I find if I don't set a goal, I'd still be doing housework, because then I putter around and I don't focus. So, I'm done. We are going to go just driving around. I don't really know where I'm taking you. It's just a gorgeous day. And got a few hours before I have to get the kids. All right, off we go. City Hall, and I thought maybe I could sketch City Hall, but there's all these bikes out front, so I thought I would videotape it. I think Dad would think it was kind of cool. Oh, that might just be a safety vest. Oh no, that white one's a cop bike, I think. Yeah, it's got the light on it. That's really cool. Dad used to race bikes and he knows what they are. Oh, that's cool. That one has fire department on it. There's this photographer over there too, so they might be heading out of town. That's a drag star, Dad. Yamaha. That's the kind of helmet Scott would want. He'd want the one with the spike. Might just be a whole group of Bermudians, actually. Some Harleys. Wow. Yeah, Bermuda Long Riders Motorcycle Club. Oh, I haven't gotten yelled at yet. Oh my God, look at that. I wouldn't want to knock any of these over. Holy hell. Look at that. Jeez. Well, Scott would like that. Places to put your sunglasses. Live to ride, ride to live.
Afternoon.
Oh my God, Dad, look at that. 106 cubic inches. Complete with a cup holder. Wow. And a Honda. Cool. I'm just glad I didn't get yelled at. I think they're pretty proud of their bikes. So look at this. This thing's insane. Oh my God. It's got pins all over it. Pretty cool. Have I ever showed you the inside of City Hall? I think I did. I'll go in anyway.
Wow, it's a expensive hobby, eh?
Oh, yeah.
There's the offices in there, and then upstairs is the Bermuda National Gallery. And then in there is the Cameron Theater, so they do like plays and stuff in there. Picture of the Queen. So you're not allowed to film in the gallery, obviously. But I'm wondering if I could just go over on this, hello pigeon, sorry. Just go over on this wall and maybe do a quick little sketch. I just want to go somewhere where no one's really watching me. I did my little sketch of City Hall. I always get freaked out when I'm like sitting somewhere like this and there's like all this wall and someone sits like 2 inches from me. Oh, it's a close person. It's a close sitter. Freaks me out a little bit. And this is when I panic. I always like, please dear God, let my bike be here. I hate this feeling. Oh, I see green. Okay. I see it. I'm always scared it's gonna get stolen.
I think it's the prettiest one. Oh, look.
It's like when someone parks really close to you in a car. It's the same for a scooter. Just his bike is probably more expensive than mine, and I really don't want to knock his over. This should be good.
Ugh. Tell everybody what you just got on your geography.
48 out of 50. Bam. 12-page essay. Bam.
Your test was a 12-page essay?
Basically.
I had my hand out. You left me hanging.
There were a lot of maps and graphs and papers.
Okay, Kerrigan and I created a sing-along.
I'm not singing.
You know you want to.
No.
We did this when she was a little bit younger, and she used to go to gymnastics.
Oh!
Hello!
Hi! Kerrigan, did you show your mom your geography, or did you tell her about it?
She's just telling me.
Yeah.
Very good.
It's like a 48 out of 50?
48. Yes. How was the concert?
It was so much fun!
Oh my God, that's so awesome!
We talked about it a bit in geography.
Did you?
So Bryn will tell you about it.
Oh, that's so cool.
But yeah, they had like these wristbands
that
like lit up different colors for different songs.
And
they were like
synced
to the beat of the music.
Are you serious?
Yeah, it was awesome.
Oh, and Shawn Mendes opened?
Yeah, he was good too.
Oh,
we
wow.
didn't really see much of him.
Yeah.
Like, we got in at 4 and then had to eat dinner and then get there.
Yeah. Oh my God. That's awesome.
It was a really good night.
That's fun.
Yeah.
Cool. Have a good weekend.
Lots of moms and daughters and girls all going out.
Yeah. Cool. See ya. That was a girl's geography teacher. They went, her and a bunch of other teachers went to the Taylor Swift. Oh, there's Bryn. Now we really can't do our sing-along. She's not gonna let us.
What song do they?
Pardon?
What song do they? It's Maybe.
Maybe
no.
Far away, or maybe real nearby.
This is weird. I made a guy in D&T today.
Pouring her coffee.
He cared more about my guy. I haven't finished coloring his pants.
Oh, fun!
Boom.
Oh, does it, do his clothes come off?
No.
Oh, that's really cool. That's really fun. Okay, where'd you bring it? That's really cute, hun. You signed it, very good. That's really neat. Wait, how many pieces is it?
Two.
Oh, his arms fit onto his body. That's really cool. Look at Miss Bryn waiting for us to come get her. All right, she's not going to want me to videotape, so I'm just going to say thanks for watching.
Don't let her know.
Where's my tablet?
Don't let her know you're videotaping.
Okay. Hello? Hey.
Good.
I don't know. She's just getting in the car. Bryn, did you get prefect?
Yeah.
Did you?
Senior prefect, yeah.
You got senior. She got senior. Good for you, hon. Yay. Awesome. All right. Okay. Bye.
But
were
my you name seen? Was called first. So I don't
yeah,
know.
She was called first.
Really?
Like, we all went up and stood in the front of the assembly.
Yeah.
And then she said, can these people step forward? Because they're going to be the leaders. So then she called my name first.
Good for you.
Yeah, but it's really hot.
It's hot.
Why is the camera anyway?
Because we're videotaping. We just videotaped that moment. You guys want to get a snookoon?
Yes. Yeah.
We're gonna get a snow cone.
Where?
At the snow cone place.
Where is that?
So we just got snow cones and a smoothie. Over here there's like a little tent thing set up by Church Bay Beach. So we got strawberry, Kerrigan got mango, and Bryn got a strawberry smoothie. It looks chocolate.
Yeah.
Is it good?
Yeah.
Alright, so our weekend has officially begun. Thanks for watching. Hope you have a good weekend, and I'll be back with some more videos soon. All right, take care. See ya.